So the childhood vaccine schedule isn't random. It's actually put together based on a child's immune system, their ability to respond to the vaccines, and then the threat that those diseases pose to the children. At different ages, children are more vulnerable to different infections, or if they get the infection, they are more vulnerable to having more severe disease, ending up in the hospital or the ICU, or actually dying from that infection. So that's exactly why the vaccine schedule is designed for different protection at different age. You hear a lot of numbers with the number of vaccines that kids get, but if a child gets every recommended vaccine, then up to age 18 years of age, they would actually get 72 vaccine doses, and that's if they get influenza vaccine and COVID vaccine every single year. The higher numbers that you sometimes see are adding other vaccines in that aren't in the routinely recommended schedule, or even saying that MMR vaccine, which is a single shot, they'll count that as three vaccines. So that's misleading. The MMR vaccine has been studied for years and is extremely safe. That's the only vaccine we have in the US that protects against measles, mumps, and rubella, German measles. You can't get an M, M, or R vaccine. There are no separate measles, mumps, or rubella vaccine. The only way to get protection against those diseases is with that 3-in-1 shot. If parents are considering delaying some vaccines, then I would recommend talking with your healthcare provider about that, because certain vaccines are in the vaccine schedule specifically to protect children when they're most vulnerable. So for example, with the DTaP vaccine, diphtheria, tetanus, and the acellular pertussis vaccine, that vaccine is kind of front-loaded in the vaccine schedule at 2, 4, and 6 months of age, because children less than 1 year of age, and especially less than 6 months of age, are the ones who are most vulnerable to getting severe cases of whooping cough and dying from that disease. So you don't want to delay that vaccine. And similar with Hib vaccine or PCV, pneumococcal conjugate vaccine, those are protecting children against meningitis and other serious infections when they're most at risk of getting those. So you really don't want to delay those vaccines and risk your child getting a serious infection like meningitis. Yes, so all the vaccines in the childhood vaccine schedule have been rigorously studied. Before they're approved by the FDA, thousands of children receive these vaccine doses, and they're intensively studied by researchers. Parents keep diaries of any kind of significant reaction that might occur, and they're followed up by clinicians and researchers to measure, for example, any kind of injection site redness or swelling. And then longer term follow-up is also done in these studies. And then once these vaccines are approved by the FDA and then recommended in the general population, further study is done by several vaccine safety systems. Some of those are in the private sector. So for example, the Vaccine Safety Data Link, which involves millions of children in HMO style databases, and then others are studied by the federal systems. So we've got a lot of safety data. If any kind of safety signal is detected in those, immediately we'll hear about it.